Welcome back, guys, to my channel. Today, this is going to be the second part. You know, in the first part, we'll basically go through how the end project really looks like. So starting from today, so basically we'll do all going to be hand, basically all coding. So I'll be coding very slowly so that you guys can follow along as we as I type the new code, okay? So all right, let's go ahead and get started. Very first thing, I'm going to go ahead and start my Visual Studio here. Visual Studio 2019, and I'm going to name this project as Stock Market Analyzer. All right. Sorry, I don't mean to do that. Anyway, let's go ahead and create a new project here from the Visual Studio template. This is going to be it's going to be ASP.NET Web Application. Basically, under this, all the .NET Core, all this application belongs in this. So I'm going to choose. I'm going to choose this ASP.NET Core Web Application. This is the template I'm going to choose. This template is for the previous version of .NET for the .NET framework, and this one is for the .NET Core. That's what we'll be using. And this is going to be the name of our project, Stock Market Analyzer Tool. So by default, it goes into user folder. Let's go ahead and change this one. I would like to have, I have certain conventions that I follow. This is a .NET project. I'm going to put this one here. All right, that is a location I'm going to go ahead and choose, and this is my solution name, Visual Studio Solution. All right, so now let's go ahead and ask it to create this one. It provides, you know, different template based on the type of application that you are developing. You can use a different template. Since we are using, you know, a single page application using React, so I'm going to choose this template right here. So I'm going to choose a React template, and let's go ahead and create this one. And the other thing I want you to, assuming you have downloaded all the required software, let's make sure you have already installed your node and it's working fine. Here is my latest, just to make sure if your node application is already installed, you can see the version number of the node when you type this command here. And also verify the NPM, by the NPM, what version of the NPM you are using. In my case, it's using that 16.14.6. Those are like, you know, it's a client-side application behind the scene. React uses a node. So Visual Studio by default, you know, when you, there's a couple of ways you can do it. When you download Visual Studio, you can download node along with, or later on you can download separately. Whichever way you prefer is, it should work either way. All right, so a couple of observations here, right? When it provides you a template, here is this new folder called Client App, and this is where all our all our React-related code will be residing. It's, they follow certain pattern. Here is a source folder. Inside that, we have component, all those things. Okay, and then the thing to notice about this one is like, when trying to install this, it might, when you're trying to run this application in the beginning, it might take a while. You might be wondering why it will take a little longer to see what's going on here. So you can see, we want to see all the dependency here, right? For example, go into this project. So all it's a dependency. So what it happens is like, basically it also includes the node, because like, As you have developed a node application, there are so many dependencies it has to download. It has to do the same thing. You will have this node folder, even though it is not included in the proxy, but you can see, you can see here, There is this feature called hide or display, you know, like hidden file, hidden folders. That's where you can see all node related projects here, all the dependencies it has to download. Anyway, let's go ahead and start this project here. Just to see how does it look like, you know, but it's basically right now, we haven't done anything. We're just, you know, playing with the default setting provided by Visual Studio 2019. See, that's what I'm talking about here. See, when you, you might have, you know, as a .NET developer, you might have noticed this one too. Behind the scene, see this thing right here, it is telling you what's really going on right now. It's a loading, it has to load all the dependency related to Node and other things related to server side. So you see right here. Okay, now the build becomes successful. It's eventually fire up and you know it uses the local express service here, website here, uses it by default ports. Okay, that is basic template. Let's see how this application looks like. Come on. Oh, other thing I want you to when you're developing either React application, basically, if you are developing React application using other way, meaning like you can use other so many different tools that you can, you know, develop, you can use to create a React application. There is something called a tool created by Facebook called Create React App tool. Anyway, any of those, whatever tool that you are using, most important file is something called package.json. If you open this file here, it lists all the dependency. So in the beginning, when the Visual Studio starts, when the very first time, it basically tried to download all these dependency. All this, you know, node application dependency right here. For example, we are using React. It's grabbing the most recent version of React right here, React DOM, anything, all the things that we need to start our application. And here is this is kind of cool because like it need to, because like when it, we, you can use the NPM start later on, let's say you need to, you know, you need to have grab additional dependency to your project, then you can use command line tool, like I said, NPM tool, to install this here. Anyway, that is that. Let's go ahead and see our application. This is what it looks like by default. Like I said, this is a single-page application. So I just want to show you how it really, let's look it into, go into developer tools and see how it's really behaving. So for example, if I go into network tab here, as you can see, goes to a fixed data. Let me restart and say, all right. See, as you can see, when this link was called behind the scene, what happened was it called this service right here. We have a controller, corresponding controller, like a weather forecast, and it had a GET request. And based on that, it fits this JSON data here, JSON array data here. Okay, and this is how it is binding. All the binding is everything is done by the React. That is what we'll be tapping to. All right, so that is that with nothing special. We haven't done anything so far. It's all default project provided by Visual Studio. This very first thing we can do, let's go ahead and create a new project here. We're gonna create our models, but I do not like to have model in the same project as in here, because like, I would like to have separate project for the models. So I'm gonna go ahead and create a new project here. This project is going to be a .NET standard class library so that we can share. The idea is like we should be able to share it either in a .NET framework or .NET core or whatever. You know, we should be able to share this later on whenever we need it. All right, the convention I'm gonna use is the same as a project name, but however, I'm gonna say .model. So it's kind of, all right, here is our model, project. I have already created this model, so let's go ahead and create this class here called stock history. This is our first model, so you don't have to me typing all this, you know, getter and setter. All right, this is how our model is going to look like, because we need to know, other thing, we need, of course, we need to store the company information here. So let's go ahead and create a new class called company info also. We're going to generate in the same pile. And I also have this template already, company info. Just grab it from here, that way you don't really have to wait, just type in getter and setter. We can expedite that, you know. Okay, anyway, so this is our, let's do a name resolution here. Using the system. Okay. So we had a double classes here. Let's go ahead and get rid of that. All right, cool. So we have a two classes here. Class called company info, and then another class that are model called stock history. As you can see, we have a reference to stock history. So, but what happens behind the scene, when we create a database, this can be a foreign key to history has a foreign key to company info. I just created this something called formatted date, so that I would like to display date in this particular year, month, and day format. This is not really part of the model, but I realized it might be useful, so I added that one there. Okay, that is our, so next thing, as you might have guessed, I'm gonna create a new project here. It's also going to be a class library. .NET class library in C#, and then I'm going to call this one as and call this as a database. It has to basically, this is going to be our database context, so it can connect to our SQL Server database. All right, let's go ahead and create this one. Okay, that is that. All right, even before that, let me make sure we have all the dependency here. Because we'll be using here a SQL Server. So let's go ahead and add a we need to get our dependency here, because we need to use right here. Let's go ahead and add project dependency. Let's go to. Sorry for that. I'm trying to go into NuGet Package Manager. We need to have reference to Entity Framework. Let's go into Browse, Entity Framework Core. This is the first dependency we need. All right. All right, as you can see in our database project, we have a dependency to, here's our framework, .NET Core. And we also need, we can also install tool here. And then I would also like to install, because we'll be using database SQL Server. So let's go ahead and install the SQL Server also. All right, here's Entity Framework Core.SQL Server with the same version. Let's go ahead and install that version. All right. right, I'm gonna go ahead and accept that one. All right, let's go ahead and close this. I think we are done in terms of, so we have basically dependency to Entity Framework Core, Entity Framework SQL Server, and tools. Maybe we can throw in design also if we need, but if we need it, we'll add that later. All right, so we also need to have a dependency, Prosig dependency to our model. So let's go ahead and add the model also because we need to, all right. So we have a Prosig dependency with the model, and this is the packages that we got from the, you know, from the NuGet package manager server. That is that. Okay, the next thing we're gonna create our DB context in here, but I think because you don't have to type, wait for me typing, I might have DB context here already created. So I'm gonna grab this class and I'll just, I'm gonna say create a new class here called Stock Market Analyzer DB Context. All right, cool. So all right, so I don't need this one. Go ahead and get rid of this one. And I have a parser class. I don't need this. And I have a company info and then stock history. All right. And of course, you know, I copied the class. I have to make sure, you know, this default constructor has the same name as that. All right, cool. So the first thing we need to do is this name resolution with this one. So we need to include a bit, you know, .NET Framework Core. And of course, we need to have our model included here. Now this thing go away. And then, all right, here's our option. And right now, by default, I'm just putting my SQL Server connection string is right here. But of course, it's a bad practice. We generally put that information into app settings of the project. So just for right now, for the demo purposes, you know, it should be fine. But I want to call this database name. I'm using the, you know, the Windows authentication. And of course, in real life, when you deploy this application, you need to have a user ID and password of your connection string. For now, it is okay. I'm going to call this one stock market . This is going to be our database that we'll be creating later on. Okay, so this is our DB context method here. All right, let's make sure, let's go ahead and build our application. We haven't broken anything. We wrote a bunch of code. Of course, you know, if you have been writing this in production, you know, in label code, you would have a unit test and making sure everything is passing before you write any business line of code. Anyway, guys, this is where I'm going to stop for the second part of this video. We'll be continuing with the third part, okay? Just, you know, keep waiting for the third part. Thank you so much for watching and subscribing for my videos. Thank you.